Hi there, and welcome. My name is Michael Kentenich, and I'm a Microsoft Technical Trainer. In this video, we will learn how to unleash the power of seamless software deployment with Azure Container Registry. Discover how this service can revolutionize your workflow and bring unparalleled efficiency to your business. Azure Container Registry, or ACR, is a reliable, scalable, and secure environment for your Docker container images right within the Azure ecosystem. With ACR, you can store and manage container images across all types of container-based deployments, simplifying your path from development to release. Let's consider a real-life situation. You're part of a global software development team working on an application that needs to be deployed across multiple regions. The application is containerized using Docker, and you have different versions for testing, staging, and production environments. In the past, managing and deploying these images was a challenge for your team. Different versions got mixed up, leading to unnecessary delays and potential errors. But then, your team started using Azure Container Registry. Now you have a centralized, secure registry to manage all your Docker images. You can easily deploy the right version of your application to the right environment at the right time. No more mix-ups, no more delays. Just smooth, efficient deployment every time. That's the power of Azure Container Registry, storing container images and streamlining your processes, improving your deployment strategy. In this video, I will explain the features and benefits of Azure Container Registry. I will describe how to use ACR tasks to automate builds and deployments, and also explain the elements in a Docker file. And also, we will look into how to build and run an image in the ACR by using Azure CLI. Azure Container Registry is a managed registry service based on the open source Docker registry. This is the place to store your container images and control who has access to these. Plus, you can leverage ACR tasks to build container images in Azure, not relying on local environments. If you use Kubernetes, DCOS, or Docker Swarm, aka the scalable orchestration systems, or Azure services like App Service, Batch, Container Apps, etc., images are pulled from the ACR into these deployment targets. How do you get images pushed to the ACR? The best way to do this would be to integrate push tasks into your continuous integration tool, like Azure Pipelines, GitHub, or Jenkins. Another way is to utilize the Azure Container Registry tasks to build container images directly in Azure, for example, every time your team commits to a Git repository. A repository holds images. Each image is an immutable snapshot of a container that works with Docker. Azure Container Registries can have both Windows and Linux images. You decide the names of the images for all your container deployments. Use standard Docker commands to put images into a repository or get an image from a repository. Besides Docker container images, ACR keeps related content formats such as Helm charts and images built according to the Open Container Initiative image format specification. The Azure Container Registry offers different service tiers or stock keeping units. These tiers have fixed prices and various options for matching the capacity and usage needs of your private Docker registry in Azure. Basic is a cost-optimized entry point for developers learning about Azure Container Registry. Standard offers increased included storage and image throughput, while Premium provides the highest amount of included storage and concurrent operations. All tiers come with the Azure storage benefits of encryption at rest and geo-redundant storage, which keeps image data synchronized in paired regions. With Premium's queue, your ACR supports on top geo-replication, availability zones, private link with private endpoints, and more. For details about all of these options and the differences in the pricing tiers, check out Microsoft Learn for more. How do you build your container images? On your local computer? Or as part of a build pipeline on an agent? ACR can do this for you too, with ACR tasks, without needing a local Docker engine installation. ACR tasks provide cloud-based container image building for Linux, Windows, and ARM. It also enables automated builds triggered by source code updates, updates to container's base image, or timers. With base image update triggers, you can automate your operating system and application framework patching workflow. Maintaining secure environments while adhering to the principles of immutable containers is made easy. ACR tasks support several scenarios to build and maintain container images and other artifacts. There's the quick task, build and push a single container image to container registry on demand. Think Docker build, Docker push in the cloud. Automatically triggered tasks will trigger on source code update, on an update for a base image, or on a schedule. With multi-step tasks, you can use a YAML file to define and run steps for creating, testing, and updating container images in the cloud. Each step in the tasks specifies a separate build or push operation for container images or other artifacts. In the next demo, I will show you how to create an ACR and use ACR tasks to build and push an image. In this video, I will show you how to use an Azure Container Registry, an ACR, to use ACR tasks to build and push a local container image to that privately hosted Azure Container Registry. I have already created an ACR, and we look at this in the portal right now. It's a normal ACR. I have used the basic SKU for this. ACR task is available for all of those, and I don't need that higher bandwidth or geo-replication feature that comes with the premium SKU, so I'm okay with this. But the container registry right now is empty. There is no repository, there's no image in it, and this is what I would like to change. For this, I will do all the remaining tasks in the terminal that is running on Ubuntu Linux on my local machine. So in here, first of all, I have already connected to Azure, and I can use now Azure CLI commands like AZ-ACR for Azure Container Registry and list to see that it actually finds and is aware of that ACR that I have deployed. If we scroll up a bit, then we should see the name in a couple of locations. And here, that is the same name that we see back in the portal in here. Now, I want to store this name just to reuse this a bit later then as well. And let me just copy this over so that I don't have to type the number in here. And I will store this in a variable that I'm going to use in my following commands. Now, before I do anything with that ACR, I will explain what the purpose is. In this folder that I'm using here, I have a small .NET application called ipcheck. It's a very simple program that just prints out the IP addresses of the local machine. So if I'm showing you what that does, I will just run it right now, and all I expect to see is a bunch of different IP addresses that my local device has currently configured. So the application works, and this is what I want to now containerize and put on the ACR. Usually, I would now start working with the Docker commands, but I don't need that when I have ACR. I can do this, I can offload this to the ACR with ACR tasks. So let's do this. Now I'm already in the right folder, so and I have access to the Azure subscription, so I can use the AZ-ACR command using the build method in here. Point it to the registry, that name I just saved in that ACR name one in here in the variable, and then I will tell it to say go ahead and create an image.
and call that IP check, like the application, provide the latest tag, and that's my choice. I could also call it version one or whatever I want to call it. And where do I find the binaries? In the local directory. That's what the dot at the end is for. So I'm telling now with this command, the system to say, upload the source code to the ACR, build the image on the ACR, create an image out of that and push it to a repository called IPCheck under the label later so I can reuse this from there. And that all happens now. And of course, it's Docker compatible. It's using the same mechanisms under the hood to do this right now. So it's uploading that image to the ACR. And the build process does not happen on my local system. It does happen on the ACR. And I did not do any special configuration up to this point or anything else. Now that this command has finished and it didn't give me any error messages or and so on, let's go back to the Azure portal and refresh or look in here into the repositories again, and let's hit refresh. And I should see now a repository, which is a way of organizing the images that are uploaded of the name IPCheck, and there it is. If I open this up, I should see the latest tag in here was just created. If I open this up, I cannot look into the image really. It's just showing me metadata for this one. And it gives me also the commands that I can now use to pull this. This is for some reason also obfuscated, which I don't really need in here. So it's just showing me the Docker pull command in here, as you can see. And this would be what I could now use on any system to get that image downloaded from that ACR. So there you have it. ACR tasks are so powerful that you can outsource the build tasks and you don't have to manage the Docker installations on multiple workstations at the same time. You can rely on your ACR for this.
Congratulations on grasping Azure Container Registry. By using its capabilities to store container images and automate builds and deployments, you are ready to streamline your container management workflow. Empower your team with Azure Container Registry to efficiently manage containerized applications and accelerate your deployment processes effortlessly. Thanks for watching. Keep on learning.